So here's an alternative. Instead of defining a state by just creating a tuple and then getting at the fields of a state by doing an assignment, we can use something called a name tuple that gives a name to the tuple itself as well as to the individual elements. We can define a new data type called state, and I'm using capitalized letters for data types. Say state is equal to a name tuple, and the name of the data type is state, and the fields of the data type are p, me, u, and pending. So I can just go ahead and make that assertion. Name tuples is in a module, so from collections, import name tuple gives me access to it, and now I can say s equals state 1, 2, 3, 4, and I can ask for the components of s by name. So s.p, that would be equal to 1, s.me has the value 2, and so on. So how would I choose between this representation for states and the normal tuple representation? Well, the name tuple has a couple advantages. It's explicit about the types. It helps you catch errors. So if you ask for the p field of something that's not a state, that will give you an error. Whereas if you just broke up something that was four elements into these components, that would work even if it didn't happen to actually be a proper state. And there are a few negatives as well. It's a little bit more verbose, although not so much. And it may be unfamiliar to some programmers. It may take them a while to understand what name tuples mean. And I should say, we could also do the same type of thing by defining a class. And that has all the same positives. It's certainly familiar to most Python programmers, but it would be even more verbose. And here's what hold and roll look like in this new notation. So hold, we're explicitly creating a new state, and we look at the state.p, the state.u, the state.me, and the state.pending, and so on, and similarly for roll. So they look fairly similar. You notice the lines are a little bit longer in terms of we're being more explicit, so it takes a little bit more to say that. And I'm sort of up in the air whether this representation is better than the previous representation with tuples. I could go either way.